Hi guys, in this video we will see how to set up Sass using Parcel. If you are building a normal website and want to use Sass, then you need to do a lot of things even before you can get started. Parcel is a nice tool and it is quite easy to use. First we will see how to set up Sass, then we will see how to use Bootstrap and also customize default colors to something different. So let's get started.
You need to have Node.js installed on your machine. To install, you can go to nodejs.org and download from there. Once installed, open command prompt. I'll create a new directory named sass parcel and run npm init with hyphen y flag to make it a Node.js project. It will create a package.json file. Now I'll install parcel bundler and sass. Once installed, I'm opening the project in VS Code. I'm creating a source folder and a sass folder, a CSS folder. I'm creating a style.scss file. Then I'm creating an index.html file inside source. I need to create a sass rc file which contains the configuration for sass compiler. Now I am linking a style.scss file in index.html file. I am creating a sass variable. Margin size and use it in a container class. Let's specify it. Command in package.json file. I'll put the command in start script. Let's run the command. It should start the server. Since our parse and sass setup is completed, we will see how to use Bootstrap with Sass in this project. To use Bootstrap, we will install it using npm again. To install, we need to use the command npm install bootstrap, and we also need popper.js file since it is a peer dependency for Bootstrap. Once installed, I'll create an index.js file and import all bootstrap.js files from bootstrap node modules folder and link the script file in index.html file. This will get me bootstrap.js files. Now to customize colors of bootstrap, I will import sass functions and variables from bootstrap node modules. This will allow us to modify existing theme and finally import bootstrap at the end. Let's check it by creating some buttons. I have modified primary color and theme variables. Since this has only primary, it will remove all other variables for theme colors. We can get all customizable options from the Bootstrap site. Then we can modify the secondary color as well. As you can see, we have changed the default primary and secondary color for Bootstrap.